everybody. Today we're going to share with you a performance of Hamish MacCunn's epic setting of The Wreck of the Hesperus, which is a poem by Longfellow. This particular piece of work was composed in 1905, and it was written to be performed at the London Coliseum, which is a very innovative venue, which had just not long opened. And it was composed to really take advantage of some of the particular aspects of this venue. And one of the things that was really special about the performance was it was designed to be shown with a magic lantern show. Now, of course, we don't have a magic lantern, and it's very difficult, it would be very difficult for us to share a magic lantern show with you online. So what we've done is we've asked for people to submit artwork, and Marie and Jen, who I've got here with me, have been looking after this project. So I wonder whether perhaps you want to just talk a little bit about who has sent artwork in for us.
Yeah, we've had so many people from all ages send in artwork. Lots of people we know from the university. But there's also so many people online who have reached out. It's really been interesting as well, the variety we have as well. We've had drawings, we've had visual illustrations, and it's really been fantastic to see like the community come together.
Yeah, some of the digital art that we've got has just been amazing. I'm really looking forward to seeing it. And then I think it's going to look really nice in contrast to some of the children's pieces. And it's going to be such a lovely mixture.
Yeah, it's been really great to see the submissions from children and adults. And one of the things we did when we sent out the call for artwork was to include a link to the famous film version, which dates, I think, from the 1930s, and it features Mighty Mouse. Now, of course, probably you know that the story of The Wreck of the Hesperus doesn't necessarily have a happy ending. But in the Mighty Mouse version, Mighty Mouse swoops in and he saves the day, as he does in most of his stories. One of the things we asked of people who were submitting artwork was to think of perhaps an alternative ending if they didn't want to draw the rather sad ending of the original poem. And we did have one submission that did that, didn't we?
Yeah, we had a really interesting submission that sort of has a bit of an alternative ending, whereby a ghost ship comes to the rescue of the Hesperus.
That's right, and this idea of the ghost ship really somehow seems to fit with the sort of feel of the poem in a way. So I think that's a really innovative and appropriate solution to the ending.
Yeah, definitely.
Now it's been a few years since we've actually sung this piece. Both the recordings that we've used to create this performance, I think, are from 2017. But it's certainly a piece that we look forward to revisiting again in the future, because it really does deserve, I think, to be better known. It's got a fantastic ending. Honestly, I could listen to it all day. It's so kind of exciting. And I think when it was first written, it actually was quite well known as a piece. It was quite heavily marketed by the publisher Novello, and it received quite a lot of performances by amateur choirs. But it really has been largely forgotten. So it's really great. I hope that this reaches a wide audience, and I hope that perhaps it inspires other choirs to think about resurrecting this piece.
Thank you. Thank you.